a special prime time edition of the NFL on EA Sports. See Jimmy Garoppolo and the San Francisco 49ers taking on Jalen Hurts and the Philadelphia Eagles.
We are sandwiched between Fort Worth and Dallas, Texas in Arlington at the luxurious AT&T Stadium. Tonight we've got a good NFC matchup in store between the Philadelphia Eagles and the San Francisco 49ers. AT&T Stadium, fielded just outside the goal line and out a little across the 25 to the 27. Philly's offense getting ready, and Jalen Hurts ready to lead them. The second round pick who started his career at Alabama, then finished with an electric senior season at Oklahoma.
Tremendous production in college at two different universities, and this is a guy who was a finalist for the Heisman Trophy. Still much more of a runner than a thrower, but has plenty of arm and is capable of making the big throws downfield. And don't underestimate his ability to think the game. Remember, he's the son of a coach.
They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts. He's going to take a shot right away. And it'll be incomplete. Good job staying with him defensively, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, they certainly came out firing in this one, and while that one was incomplete, I can't imagine that'll be the last shot that they take in this game.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Hurts sets up to throw it. Throw right side, caught by Goddard, the tight end. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 5 yards, now it's third and five. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a third and five. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And this play going to be stopped in its tracks at the 32, and obviously well short of the first down. Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to fourth down.
And partner, I would guess that in his headset he was hearing from his coach, it's third down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
Here's Aaron Sipos out now to punt on fourth down. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Out comes the San Francisco offense as they are led out by their quarterback, the man known as Jimmy G. That's Jimmy Garoppolo.
And Jimmy Garoppolo has shown that he can be a Super Bowl quarterback, but his biggest problem, his ability to stay healthy and remain on the field. When able, he's a capable quarterback prone to winning games both in the regular and postseason.
Going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line. Well, certainly not how he wanted to start his night. First throw of the game, an INT.
Yeah, it's not easy, but he's got to try and wipe that one away from the memory banks. And let's face it, it's not often a quarterback and a defensive back have a lot in common. But one thing, because they have these individual-type plays, they've got to have short memories, don't they? DB gets beat, wipe it away, quarterback throws a pick, has to do the same thing.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Here's Hurts to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Sanders. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
On second and inches, Hurts. His throw incomplete.
I didn't like the look of that play right from the beginning. I thought he should have seen the coverage that was there. Tried to force it in. That one, he's fortunate, just fell incomplete.
An incomplete pass on second down leads us to third and inches. Throwing is Hurts. This is complete to Watkins on the slam. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Give him three on the keeper there, and it is second down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
They will run for the first time with Miles Sanders. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about three.
Well, at that rate, picking up 3 yards a carry, you and I both know that doesn't cut it in this league and trying to get first downs, unless you're playing four down football. Then that's a whole different situation, but I don't think that's what they're trying to do here. Third and four, though, is still manageable.
Hurts. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. That is Nick Bosa from out on the edge who worked his way in for the sack.
Well, it's about how teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
Yeah, you know he hated taking the loss there on third down. Now to try the Eagle field goal, Jake Elliott. The kick by Elliott is good. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. So the turnover leads to points as they add three there.
Yeah, what a sequence there and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. Here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Set to take over again here on offense, Jimmy G and the 49ers. And he'll need to find a way to shrug off the opening drive, if you can even call it a drive. One play and an interception, so he's got to forget that.
I know that in today's football, we have a good number of coaches who don't look at time of possession the way that the old school guys did. But there's still a place for it. I think that on this drive, after having thrown that interception, they're going to want to eat up a little bit more clock and run some offense and give their defense a little bit of a break.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 24. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Second and seven. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Now they're staring at a third and eight. That last play, backwards a yard. Plays like we just saw there. That's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. To throw, it's Garoppolo. And he will find his man, Samuel. Touchdown, 49ers. Debo Samuel, 58 yards. And the 49ers have now taken the lead. Robbie Gold on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. So that drive, four plays. And the end result for the 49ers, a touchdown. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. From the six. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Eagles coming out as they get ready. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10, right at the 30. He'll start with a handoff to Sanders. And he's got room. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Well, CD, a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast in the open field, but, man, his first step is so quick, too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Here's Sanders. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. He'll get this complete to Jalen Reagor. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
People worry about throwing the out route because often it can get jumped, and that can turn into either an incompletion or an interception. But not on that one. Everything came together, and he catches it and goes over the sideline.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. That swung out wide to Sanders. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you go the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard, stop short of the 35. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Third down, they'll run it with Sanders. And brought down, but not before he was able to break the tackle, and the extra effort moves the sticks.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll set up a throw. Over the middle, complete. It's Watkins. And he'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7.
Ah, that's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we can talk about finding the soft spot. Defensively, how do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot they want to get into. That's what we call not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. But it's hard to do because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards him. Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. And I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Play fake. Here's Hurts. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Here's second and 10. They'll look to throw here. And this one complete to Smith. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. He'll look to throw. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off inside the 10, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points no matter what. At worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say your points on that drive, this could cost them.
The 49ers offense making its way back out there. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 from back at their own 10-yard line. They'll try the left side. Mitchell, and a short gain here across the 10 to the 12. Milton Williams there on the tackle.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Now a throw here to his running back, and able to get it across the 20 before they get to him.
I like the play design there. They occupied the defense downfield, everyone trying to account for someone, but unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield, and he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
They'll run on first down. It's Mitchell, and he'll take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Right back to Mitchell on second down. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-7-3 the score on EA Sports. Couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up third and two. They'll try the left side. It's Mitchell. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Russ, we've learned over the years, just because a guy plays left tackle doesn't mean he doesn't have run blocking abilities. And we just saw it there. Controlled the line of scrimmage, created a big game.
That's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash too.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Now they'll throw with Garoppolo. Trying for Ayuk, but it's intercepted. picked off by Avante Maddox. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD. So a pick six there out of the nickel package. They went with five DBs.
Almost becoming the base package in the NFL is the nickel. Hard to throw against. That was demonstrated one more time. A pick six going the other way.
For the extra point, Jake Elliott. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away from the six. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. And the 49ers getting set to trot out there. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back
yeah,
in.
But they told him, they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
On first down, Mitchell, and he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
From the 29, Garoppolo. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
On third down, Mitchell, and he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Well, after an interception, last thing you want to do is go three and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told him, if you don't take care of this football, you have to answer to me later. You definitely want to take care of it, pick up first downs.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They fake the give. Now Garoppolo looks to throw. Gets this one to Juszczyk. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot, because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. But he's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put
there. Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there you might out of a smaller back. Now a give, right side. It's Mitchell. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done, because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
The Niners on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This will be 3rd and 5.
That's complete. It's Brandon Ayuk. And he is going to have a Niners first down by about a yard as they find a way to convert there on 3rd down and 5.
This is a nice job of just taking what the defense is going to give you on 3rd down. You're not looking for a big play downfield. You just want to find something that can get you past the marker. They found it and were able to keep the drive moving.
Two first downs have them up near midfield now on 1st and 10. There's Garoppolo to throw. He'll dump that one off to Mitchell. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, 2nd down. That's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
From just shy of midfield, Garoppolo. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
To make it 3-for-3 on 3rd down conversions. They need a yard here. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Throwing now is Garoppolo. Got a man, that's Ayuk. 7 yards, the pickup there. Yeah, he went in route there from the slot for the completion.
Love how he runs his routes, because it's all setting up your defender. Give him a little something one way, take it the other way. Head and shoulder fake. Sometimes you make one step to the outside, then break it inside. Really well run route.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Garoppolo. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. And he has another 1st down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 22-yard line.
I tell you what, it looks like he's shaking off that pick 6 just fine. It's not just defensive backs that have to have short memories. Quarterbacks utilize that as well. A much more confident throw right there.
It's Garoppolo. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on 1st down on the sack. Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys that you turn loose to try and get to the guy who's going to throw the football. The tackles, usually more of the run-stuffing variety. But the way this game is advanced, you're wanting a little bit of everything out of all of your guys. But let's just go ahead and break it down and make it simple. The guy who's the right defensive end versus a right-handed quarterback, that's the blind side. He's going after the quarterback. He's going to put him on the ground.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete.
Well, that play was certainly a little bit different because on the previous play, he was sacked. This time, protection a lot better, had time to survey the field, and still couldn't find an open receiver.
The Niners on third down. No problems to this point. A perfect 5 for 5. This will be 3rd and 19. Working from the gun, Garoppolo. Checks this one down. It's Mitchell. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. That one good for only 6, and it leaves him with a 4th down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a 4th down?
So Garoppolo off, coming on is the veteran Robbie Gould for the 49er field goal. From the left hash, it's a 42-yard attempt. The kick by Gould is good, and that will knot us up at 10. A 15-play drive, and it results in 3 points. So some disappointment?
It's funny. We had our conference before the game with the offensive coordinator. What did he tell us? I just want every drive to end in a kick, right? An extra point, a punt, or a field goal. Well, in this case, I think it is a little bit of a disappointment because it did end in a kick, but that type of a drive should end in the end zone.
All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Jalen Hurts in this offense trotting back out. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. They start on the ground here at Sanders. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's 2nd and 1 yard. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. And he'll be brought down right around the 37.
2nd and 1, and people want to run the football. This is what every back in the league is supposed to do, exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the 1st down.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. With a little pop pass on the jet sweep. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on him before he could get much out of it.
On 2nd down now, it's Sanders, and he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
The Eagles on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. From the gun, it's Hurts, rolling to his right, and he will slide to a stop. He does have the 1st down.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play, a perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a 1st down.
On 1st and 10, it's Sanders. 44 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
And when you get good yardage like that on 1st down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. Coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coach's two-minute drill.
Hurts Roger taken in by Smith. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 27-yard line.
Bartney sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep and curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot of fun. It's almost like you said, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go. Let's see who's faster.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. Flush to his right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Second and 10, we're all knotted up at 10, but it appears that may change soon. Only question is, will they have to settle for three? Eluding the pressure right. And they'll get this down to the 10. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. They'll drop to throw. And Sanders has got it complete. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. They've been in the red zone three times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second and goal? And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders there to make the grab. And the Eagles have moved out in front.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front, and now see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of the second quarter. Now, I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Elliott on for the extra point. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17-10. So that one a long 11-play drive, and it was capped off by an Eagles touchdown. after the touchdown. Here's Elliott on to kick it away. Taken in at the 3. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. A look at the running back. The man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff?
Yeah.
Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. Throwing on first is Garoppolo. That's over the middle and caught by Ayuk. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout, as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. To throw again on second down, Garoppolo. He's got Ayuk once again. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 45-yard line.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time you wait for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Drops this underneath, it's Mitchell. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. So we've reached halftime here, and it's our visitors, the Eagles, leading this one. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far, and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The 49ers going to have the football and trailing on the scoreboard as we get back underway on EA Sports. Taking it about the 1. And able to get this out to the 25. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. And they trail here to begin the second half. What's going to be a key for them to get back in the game?
I think they're right there, and I think this game is still up for the taking for them because we always talk about turnovers. They had 2 of them in the first half, and once you start talking about if you have 3, 4, or 5, you know it's beyond difficult to try and win a football game with that. Those have to be eliminated. If they take care of the ball, they've still got a shot.
On first down, Garoppolo. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
From the 27, Garoppolo. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked up by Anthony Harris. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Now to add the extra point. And the lead is up to 14. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fielded just outside the goal line. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30. San Francisco set to go on offense once more. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go-around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful, because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though.
Now Garoppolo to try again after the pick six. And his throw is incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. Second and 10. Garoppolo now. Again, looking for Samuel, this time the catch made. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
They'll run on first down. It's Mitchell. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. It was T.J. Edwards who brought him down.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Fletcher Cox forced his way through, drops him for a loss of 10 yards.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
So the sack of Garoppolo, and now what can they come up with on third and long? They'll set up to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
He went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. Here comes Rager. A 40-yard punt, 5 yards on the return, and the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. Jalen Hurts in this offense trotting back out. And he had the touchdown on the last drive, also 4 for 4. Very, very effective. What does he need to do to translate that forward into this drive?
Not think that what he saw in coverages last time is exactly what he's going to get again. He's got to play ahead and start thinking to himself, okay, we just did that. What are they going to take away now? What do we go to as a counter and continue to encourage his offensive line to continue to give him time?
They were really good on the last drive. On first down, Hurts. Into the secondary, past the 40. And all the way up to the 45-yard line.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And Hurts able to show off some of that elusiveness as he slides to the ground there and in the process picks up the first down.
Containing him is becoming a big problem. We've already seen this once earlier on this drive.
Yeah, and so now two times this has happened. Do you adjust something?
Yeah, I think you do. I think you have to start thinking about your rush lanes. Try not to either get too wide or too narrow. Make sure someone is there waiting for him to take off.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Running right, here's Sanders. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 56 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now a carry for Sanders. And he'll take this down for about 4 yards down to the 15.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. 6 yards left on second down. Hurts sets up to throw it. Quick slant here to Smith. And the Eagles are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
Go play action with Hurts. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. A great effort there. There to make the grab. And the Eagles able to push further out in front.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical. That's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Elliott good with a PAT. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. So the drive there took 6 plays. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone. The touchdown. Here's Elliott on to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. They're down 3 touchdowns to this point, needing to put something together as they have it 1st and 10. This time to the tailback. Yeah, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. Now Garoppolo. To the right side, it's caught by Mitchell. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. That'll leave them with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
That's a nice design there. But sometimes, though, you get so many blockers out ahead of you, they kind of slow you down and force you to adjust. You always appreciate guys trying to help you, but maybe one less there could have turned this into a bigger game.
Garoppolo looking to throw on 3rd and 2. Open man is Ayuk, complete. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the 1st down.
On 1st down, Mitchell, and he'll work this forward for about 3 at 2nd down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Garoppolo. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Fletcher Cox, his 2nd sack of the night.
Well, we knew this guy wasn't especially fleet of foot, but he tried to conjure up some escapability, but there was no way he was getting away on that one.
last sack. It puts Garoppolo and the 49ers in a tough spot. They face a third and long. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. And this is going to be incomplete.
No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the five, all the way down at the two-yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
Eagles offense back out, getting set for this next drive. And they will begin with, should we call it, far from ideal starting field position, their own two-yard line.
So what's your definition of ideal?
The one-yard line on the other side of the field.
Yes, exactly right. So, yes, your definition is apropos in this case.
They go with Howard to begin the drive. And he'll take this up to about the 7 or 8 yard line. It's a 6 yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
And that run, that changes the whole mentality about the drive right there. They were starting on their own 2 yard line. They just wanted enough space to pump the football successfully. Now they're talking about putting together a drive.
On 2nd down and 4, Hurts. Open man is Goddard, the tight end.
Just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw it, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to 1.
Inside 4 minutes to go, 3rd quarter. They'll run on 1st down. It's Sanders, and he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's 2nd down.
At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to home and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
To throw on 2nd and 6, Hurts rolling to his left. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's 3rd down.
Looked to me like they adopted what my kindergarten teacher always said. If at first you don't succeed, try again. And finally, able to hold him in check. He'd been carving him up running the ball.
That's the first time I think I've seen where the coverage was good downfield, and they accounted for him and stopped him for a short pickup.
Yeah, I don't think it was a big adjustment, but much more emphasis on making sure they knew where he was when he decided to take off and go. And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the 3rd quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
Throwing is Hurts. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be 2nd down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Hurts, and this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 40.
This offensive game plan has just been sensational. I mean, when you think about all the different ways they've gotten their receivers open so far, it's really been impressive. Scheme, design, execution.
So 1st and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. They'll go option to the short side. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. And he's going to lose yardage here. As they will switch ends as time has run out on this third quarter of play. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So after a rare misstep on this drive, they'll try to make amends on second and 15. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. And he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Another run here with Sanders. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down in a nice little game. A good effort there, 9 yards, but it's going to leave them looking at a fourth and one.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. The kick by Elliott is good. And that will extend the lead out to 24. So it's 3 more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. San Francisco's offense returns to the field and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He'll get this into the hands of Ayuk. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Now a second down and 6. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. He'll get this to Jennings over the middle. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. To throw is Garoppolo. That's to Mitchell out of the backfield.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Again, they'll throw with Garoppolo. A solid stiff arm. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
Garoppolo's throw taken in by Samuel. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Had to put that ball in there with a little extra zip, but he put it right where it needed to be.
Yeah, and that little extra pace that he had on the pass, that required a little extra concentration for him, didn't it? Ball can get on you pretty quick in that manner, and he handled it well and picked up the first down.
On first down, Mitchell. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Coming up on second and seven.
To throw, it's Garoppolo. And that's dropped underneath to Mitchell. And this will be a gain of six when it's all said and done. Down to the 15 from the 21.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
On third down, it's Mitchell. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10.
57 yards on the ground for him now as he's done that on 15 carries.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one, you know the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive lineman, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
Signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Mitchell. He pushes forward for maybe three down to the 6 yard line.
Do you think after that last run, they're thinking to themselves, we had to wait all day to play this night game, and we're still not able to run the ball the way we want to?
Yeah, this defense, they've risen to the challenge all evening long. The 6 yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. Touchdown! Juwan Jennings from 6 yards away. And the 49ers make some inroads here on that deficit. Will come up and go for two. They're going to try and run. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one.
But they couldn't be happy that they were having to stop a two-point conversion because that means they gave him a touchdown. But a little solace there. You saw some good gang tackling, stacking him up before he gets to the end zone.
We talk about offensive units putting in more two-point period sessions in practice. Defensively, do you do the same?
Absolutely. You have to, because you never know how aggressive these offenses are going to be in games nowadays.
after the touchdown. It's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. This will be fielded inside the five. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. Now that should give him a spark. He's across the 40 to the 43.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And last time they were able to churn some clock, they got the field goal, added onto their lead. But that was a drive that was so long, it should have ended in a touchdown. You know that's how they felt.
And we'll both be headed to the airport after the game, but we probably should go to the post-game press conference because someone's going to ask the head coach about this drive, and he's going to profess that he was happy to get points.
But
and we know
it?
That's not true.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
After this type of a drive, not getting a touchdown, a huge disappointment.
Hurts going to give it to Sanders on the option, and he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
They'll run with Sanders. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
Last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now Sanders. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play. So now third down coming up.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
The Eagles on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is 3rd and 9. On third down, they turn to Sanders. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
And they have just not been able to block him at all throughout this game. Seems like every other play, he's doing something in the backfield. Already got 2 sacks, and now here's a tackle behind the line.
The Eagles send out their punter now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds. And they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game. But this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complementary football. Because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Even though they were able to force the punt defensively, still a big hole to climb out of, especially at this late stage of the contest. And he gets up near the 25 to about the 24 before going out of bounds. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time, hopefully with a chance to win?
And now some disagreement down on that sideline. The red flag is out, and we're going to get a challenge. Did he
keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. Garoppolo now, first down throw. He's got Ayuk on the sideline. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
Only needing 2 yards on second down. There's Garoppolo to throw. Over the middle, the catch made by Mitchell. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. At that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
There's Garoppolo on first and 10. This pass to Jennings, and he makes a catch. They're giving those short little routes, tackled him in bounds, too. They're just not wanting to get beat over the top.
Yeah, and if you can't really get downfield, take the short routes. But now you got to have guys who can actually break tackles and increase those gains.
A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. And yet again, it's Garoppolo. Got a man, that's Ayuk. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Garoppolo looks to throw. Throw right side is going to be caught by Samuel. And he's got this down to the 35. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Now he dumps this off over the middle and inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Well, he certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Darius Slay with a pick. And the Eagles are going to take possession here at their own 3-yard line. This spot in the fourth quarter with that deficit, had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, try and get them out of it. But as you noted, this time of the game, this point on the clock, had to throw it.
Philadelphia's offense ready to give us another look. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. Set. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up.
Really shouldn't be a surprise. It's going to be hard to move people in this situation. You know they're going to bring the pressure defensively. Because I remember playing in these spots, and my coaches always say, don't be afraid to try and create a safety, too. They're going to bring pressure.
Second down, back to Sanders. And he was very fortunate there to get out of his end zone. He maybe got back to the 2-yard line. Officially nothing on that one, no gain. So they're left with still 10 to go on third down. Back to throw now in his own end zone. Looking left side for Watkins, and he's got it. And he'll go out of bounds just shy of the 20. Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal, that's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
For us, for Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we say good night from AT&T Stadium.